Hey friends, Azure Cosmos DB provides indexing metrics to show both utilized and recommended indexed paths. But do you know that you can use these indexing metrics to optimize your query performance? Tim Sander is here to show me how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, it's Azure Friday, and I'm going to learn from Tim Sander how to do indexing with Azure Cosmos DB. How are you?
Pretty good. Great to be here on the show again. I feel like we're always releasing new features in Cosmos DB, and it's awesome to have Azure Friday to go and spotlight them. Today, I'll be talking a little bit about the index metrics that we recently released for Cosmos DB. And if you've used Cosmos DB before, you know that it's a really good database to use as a developer if you don't know a lot about databases. And that's kind of a weird thing to say, right? It's the best database to use if you aren't a database expert. But in Cosmos DB, we like to be really developer-friendly by going and indexing every property by default. And for most customers, this is awesome, right? It allows you to go and develop really quickly on Cosmos DB without having to think about your database performance and things like that. You can just write code, write queries, and get instant great performance. But in a lot of cases, customers that are maybe operating at a large scale or go into production, they want the ability to go and fine-tune query performance and go and take it one step further in optimization. So that's our intention with creating these indexing metrics. We want to allow customers that maybe aren't an expert in databases or expert in Cosmos DB to be able to quickly and easily get indexing recommendations for optimizing their queries performance.
Okay, so is this really just about squeezing performance out of it? Or is this just about like, hey, these are some simple and free things that you can do that are just going to make your life better and just going to make your perf better?
I'd say it's a mix of both. It's something that you definitely don't have to do. Like if you're watching this video and Cosmos DB is working great for you right now, you shouldn't feel like this is something that you absolutely must do to improve performance. It's definitely something that is an extra optimization that you can do if you've already identified, let's say, a slow query or an expensive query that you want to go and optimize even further beyond our default indexes that we create.
Cool. Do you have the live demo I can see?
Yeah, let's actually jump over to the Azure portal where I've gone ahead and uploaded a sample fictional data set that has some retail data. So I've created a shopping database and shopping container. And in this container, we have basically different items that you could buy at a store. So this is a woman's red top that has a price of 33 and the buyer state is Montana, for instance. Now, this container, I actually just went ahead and created it with our default indexing policy. You can see here there's a slash star. So like I mentioned a little bit earlier, by default in Cosmos DB, we just go and index every single property by default. So that means if you were to, let's say, run a SQL query, let's say we do select star from C, where C dot item is equal to t-shirt. If I go and run that, or really any query, it's going to be super cheap in terms of RUs and super, super quick. This is really nice as a developer because when you're writing code, like the last thing that you want to have to think about is going and needing to go and create an index for every single property that you want to go and query on.
Did you find anything with that? Is it t-shirt or shirt?
Oh, I just used a the first name that comes to mind. I can see that returns a result here, but
I wasn't sure if we were supposed to get a result or not. But I noticed that, like you said, two RUs is really nothing, right?
Yeah. So, I mean, since this is using the index, whether you get results or not, like this one returns a few hundred results. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's 16 RUs, so also super cheap. Mm-hmm. And the reason this is inexpensive is because the query is leveraging an index on the item property.
Ah, I see.
So, again, if you're getting started, this is awesome. It allows you to develop really quickly on Cosmos DB. Now, there's two reasons that you might not want this default indexing policy, but you might want to optimize it further. The first of which would be if you had a really write-heavy workload. The more properties you index in Cosmos DB, the more expensive it is to do writes. So with this default indexing policy, where we're indexing every single property, writes are going to be expensive, right? So in a lot of cases, when customers get started, they stick with this default, but then later on when they go into production or they get further into development, they go and they tune their indexing policy to only include the required paths. Now you have two ways that you can do this. You can go and instead of doing a blanket, this slash star means basically everything. Instead of indexing everything, you can go and exclude everything by default. And then go and specify like specific paths, specific properties that you want indexed, right? And you can kind of create a list of those.
So are you saying be non-performant everywhere except be super performant in these places? Or are you just being more specific? Like I think that people want the hot path to be ideal, but they don't want to lose the ability to query anything whenever they feel like it.
That's exactly right. So if you were querying on this property here, to make the example easier, I'll call it item. If you were querying on item, this would be super performant. But then if you were querying on any other property, we obviously wouldn't have an index available. So the benefit would be you were doing writes. This is more efficient because we're only indexing one property. The drawback, of course, is it's important that your queries only use the item property. If they filter on other properties, you wouldn't be leveraging indexes.
So speaking naively, because you said that Cosmos is great for folks that are not good at databases, mm-hmm. why wouldn't I just index everything all the time? Because it would make writes expensive.
That's really the only reason. If you don't care about write performance or you don't do a lot of writes, that's totally fine to have an indexing everything policy all the time. Now, that will get you reasonable performance. I guess there is one other case where you might want to go in and customize the indexing policy. And that's with adding on something called, I'll go and revert this back, adding on something called composite indexes in Cosmos DB. And composite indexes are something extra on top of the included and excluded paths. With composite indexes, you'll add those on to provide an extra optimization for certain queries. So for instance, if you had an order by query in Cosmos DB, you'll get reasonable performance without a composite index. But you can go and add on a composite index as an extra optimization to further improve query performance.
I see. So a hot path is item and price. And that's how all my users do everything. They always include item and price. Mm-hmm. So we can index those together as a composite.
Right. If you use those together. So that's actually a great transition into just going over the index metrics because mm-hmm. composite indexes is our motivation for creating these index metrics. A lot of developers, again, we want Cosmos DB to be the best database to use if you're not an expert in databases. And a lot of developers that are using Cosmos DB do have queries that they want to optimize beyond the default indexing policy. And very often it's to optimize either write performance or to go and add on a composite index. So the indexing metrics will help you mainly with the latter, but they will also help you understand which indexes you can remove to optimize write performance. So I'm going to jump over to a console app that I've written where I have a super simple select star query that filters on shirt, basically the one that we had just run together. And it goes and populates the index metrics. So if I go ahead and run this, I'll move this down a bit so you can see the query here. Mm-hmm. I go ahead and run this. It's going to print out the indexes that we used when we executed this query. So in this case, we see that we utilize single indexes on item and the impact score was high. So the way you want to interpret this, if you had a select star policy, is you could have gone ahead and removed every single index besides the one on item and the query performance wouldn't have changed. This index on item had a very high probability of being used in the query execution, therefore was really important to have.
And then that information was just a context that you plucked out of thin air there. It was available to you as a developer, and now you have more insight into what's going on as a result of that specific query.
That's right. You don't need to be an expert in how Cosmos DB works. All you need to do is go and look at the index metrics. And this is evidence to you that this query used our index on item. So I'll go ahead and add in another query. So like I touched on earlier, there's two reasons that you might want to use the index metrics. The first of which is optimizing write performance by removing indexes that you don't need. The other is going and adding on an extra optimization to your queries by adding a composite index. And one type of query where composite indexes are really useful is queries that have a filter and order by. So if I take that that query that I had earlier that filters on item, where we say item is shirt, and then we order by timestamp, this query is actually going to benefit from a composite index. If you remember, we had a default indexing policy that's going to go in and index every property by default. But in this case, the indexing metrics also recommend a composite index. So the way you'd want to interpret this would be that we utilize these single indexes here on item and timestamp. In other words, if we only had indexes on item and timestamp, this query would have equivalent performance to what we just got now. So that's the right optimization kind of part of it. Mm-hmm. The other takeaway that you'd want to have from this is we have a potential composite index here. And if we were to add on this composite index on item and timestamp, since they're both used in the query, there's a high probability that this index would get used and further improve query performance.
Interesting. And these predictions, like it's smart. It identified that potential composite index. Should I always take that advice, or is it just something for me to then do further analysis with?
It's a great point to touch on. It's something that you should always try. I would say, like any advice that you get in life or from a recommendations engine, like if you were shopping on your favorite website, right? If you were and you got a recommendation for a product to buy, you wouldn't just go and buy that product without researching it, right? However, it probably would make sense to go explore it and see if it made sense. So our recommendation is if you see potential composite indexes, it always makes sense to try them out, but it's something that you want to go in after trying it out, go and monitor performance and make sure, of course, that it improves your performance. The best way to do that is actually once you've added on a potential composite index, go and rerun your query later on and double check that composite index is actually utilized. In which case you'd actually see it in the utilize composite indexes section, similar to how we see the utilize single indexes here.
Nice. Measure twice, cut once, as they say.
Right. And the way to measure, right, and confirm that the query used the index is this utilize section here. Like this is hard evidence that the query used the index. The potential indexes is just a recommendation. Now, we're pretty confident in that recommendation, but it's definitely something that you should verify on your own before you go and roll it out in production.
Okay.
I'll show you one more query here. And this is a similar example, except it doesn't use order by this time. What this query will do is it's going to have a filter on the item again, and also have a filter on the timestamp, where timestamp came after this value, and where the price is greater than $75. So this is a query with an equality filter, and then two greater than or less than filters. So I'll go ahead and print that out. I'll just make this bigger so you can see that. What these index metrics are showing us is we use the indexes on item, timestamp, and price. So we could have just had these indexes and the query would have gotten equivalent to performance to what we had now. Of course, because we see composite indexes here, we know that if we added on these two composite indexes, there's a high probability that the query engine would go in and use these composite indexes to further improve query performance. So if this was a query that we run very often, and we observe that it has maybe a higher U charge or we want it to be ultra low latency, our recommendation would be to go and add on these extra composite indexes to further improve query performance.
I noticed that in the index spec under potential composite indexes, you have ASC. I presume that means ascending. Is that saying that an index specification has to indicate sorting either descending or ascending?
Yeah, that's exactly what it's saying. In this case, it actually doesn't matter because the query doesn't have order by. But if you were using order by, like that previous example, the ascending or descending has to match what you have in the order by. So in this case, doesn't matter. We could either use ascending or descending and get equivalent performance. But if we had order by, this order must actually match what you have in your order by clause, whether it's ascending order by or descending order by.
Okay. So making an assumption and a guess naively, if I were to go and build Twitter on Cosmos, and Twitter typically uses a chronological timeline where I'd be sorting descending. I would want to make sure that I used descending in one of my indexes. And then maybe later someone else goes and does an ascending thing. That's certainly not going to be the hot path. So it would be okay to have one index that was descending and not have a formal index going in the opposite direction.
Yep, that's correct. You want to use composite indexes for any query that you're running again and again and again. Now there's the trade-off, of course, if you add in a composite index, there's a slight trade-off to write performance. It's not very big. So I'd say the threshold for when you want to add one on should be pretty low. If it's a mm-hmm. query that's run with any reasonable frequency, composite index is probably the way to go. But if you just ran a query occasionally, you probably don't need to worry about composite indexes.
Okay. Now, but you said any query that you're going to run again and again and again, you mm-hmm. kind of got lucky because you came with ideas of bad queries. You like showed me, here's three queries and here I can optimize them. But if I've got a Cosmos application, and how do I even start? How do I identify expensive queries? And it comes at it from a different direction.
Hmm. Yeah. The answer to that, short answer, is diagnostic logs in Cosmos DB. With diagnostic logs, you have a built-in way to go and log every single request to Cosmos DB. So what I'd recommend doing is go and turn on the diagnostic logs and do things like log the full query text, log the query RU charges, and log latency. And then after you've done that, the approach you want to take is just look at your highest latency and highest RU queries. Once you've identified them, then go and look at the index metrics for those specific queries. But I mean, that's a great point to make, Scott. That's a good first step to take, because these index metrics do assume that you already have a slow query in mind.
Very cool. So this sounds like you're really building the base of the pyramid of some really strong indexing metrics. Can you give me any preview? Is there any chance of a UI on top of this, or any kind of way that I could go and see the long tail in a formal graphical way in the future?
Yeah, so I can share a little bit about our roadmap here. Two big areas that we want to invest in. The first, obviously, is just showing this in the Azure portal, right? And having a graphical UI to go and access these. Right now, they're supported in the .NET SDK and the Java SDK. Obviously, Cosmos DB has lots of other ways that you can interact with the products. We want to go and expose the index metrics in as many of these places as possible, right, for users. The other thing that we want to invest in, and that we're investing pretty heavily on in the next year, is recommendations, particularly proactive recommendations. So these index metrics are really nice if you've already identified a slow query and you already know there's a problem. But wouldn't it be great if we could proactively tell you a lot of these things and tell you indexing recommendations, even if you don't know what your slow queries are, even if you haven't turned on diagnostic logs? So that's something that our team is thinking about, in basically a way that we really want to make the Cosmos DB user experience easier for developers that don't necessarily know a lot about tuning database performance.
Very cool. And then in closing, I understand that you had a really good blog post that digs even more deeply into indexing metrics in Cosmos DB.
Yeah, this blog is on our Cosmos DB blog page here. This is just what we had published when we released index metrics at Ignite, and it goes through some nice examples for how to enable the indexing metrics, interpreting them like we had talked about today in some examples.
All right. Well, fantastic. Thank you, Tim Sander, for hanging out with me today.
Absolutely.
All right, I am learning all about making my queries better with Azure Cosmos DB indexing metrics today on Azure Friday. Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.